variations in cognitive processes. So now we are going to see alterations in cognitive processes. So cognition means attention, perception, learning, memory, thinking, intelligence. So these are all cognitions. These cognitions, if there are any deviation from the normal cognition, that is called alteration. So that's why that things we are going to see now. This alteration in attention means the focus of our focus on any object or anything, that is called attention. So if you are failed to focus correctly, then it is called alterations. So this is, but we maintain our attention most of the time if we are normal. Example, when we read the book, there is so many sounds comes from outside environment, but we will filter everything, only we will concentrate on the book. So that is our attention if we are normal. But in some conditions like schizophrenia, hyperactivity, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, in these cases the people will not able to attend to a particular object or situation. They are very prone to get deviate from the or distracted from the object or anything where they are attentive. So this is called alteration in attention. It means if the person not able to maintain their attention in a particular object or situation, that time it is called alteration in attention, deviation in attention, in any way we can say. This is commonly affecting the schizophrenia patients and attention deficit hyperactivity children. So this is child disorder, attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. So schizophrenia patients, this type of, they are already having the problems of hallucinations, delusions, abnormal motor behavior, disorganized thinking. So for them, very prone to get distracted. They cannot able to maintain their attention. Children's attention deficit hyperactivity disorder, children's also the same problem. They cannot keep their attention in a particular object. Due to this abnormal mental problems only, they are not able to maintain. So this is called alteration in attention. So next we can see alteration in perception. Alteration in perception. So there most probably the abnormal perception is illusion. Illusion and hallucination also there. So here now we are going to see illusion. So hallucination, in some another video you can see there I may mentioned about hallucinations and its types also. Here we can see only types of illusions, that is a problem of perception problem. So here three types of illusions I want to explain. One is, you see, this is a line. Here three types means, one is horizontal vertical illusion, another one is illusion of length, another one is illusion of size. So first we can see horizontal vertical illusion. Here you can see two lines with the same length. Okay, here one line I am going to give horizontal position, another one is in vertical position. So now this one become vertical position. Both were same size, but you see now it looks small. The vertical one looks small, the horizontal one looks bigger than this line. But before that I said both are in same length. So when it comes like this, we will feel our perception is getting wrong by saying the horizontal one is lengthy and the vertical one is short. So this is one type of illusion, horizontal vertical illusion. Another one is illusion of length. You see, here also one line is there. So another line. So both are same length. Okay. So when we put some object in the end of the lines, there will be an illusion. You see, where I put an arrow mark in the end of one line and another inverted arrow mark I put another end. So now this line looks lengthy than this length. It means its height is higher than this height. It looks like that. That is called illusion. But actually both lines are in same length. So next one is illusion of size. This is round, is there. It is now two rounds are there, circles are there. Both are same size, right? You see now, I kept the right little aside from this one. Now I put small circles around this main circle. Here I put larger circles around this main circle. So now you see, before that it looks like same, but now this circle looks very smaller than this circle. So this is based on the outer circles, the illusion is happening. So this is one type of illusion. Okay. So horizontal vertical illusion, illusion of length, illusion of size. These three things are perceptual alterations, alteration in perception. Another one is alteration in learning. Learning means it is reading disorder, mathematical disorder, and disorders of written expression. These three are comes under learning alterations, alterations in learning. So reading disorder, we can say this dyslexia. One form of reading disorder is dyslexia. It means children with reading disorders have difficulty in recognizing and interpreting letters and words. So here is there, these letters and words is the children will get very difficulty to recognize and interpret. Recognize means what is that, to find that capacity, and interpreting means to understand what they have written. If they have written fan, F-A-N will be there, but they cannot recognize what they have written. A-P-P-L-E, apple will be there, but the child cannot recognize what they have written. So that is dyslexia. Dyslexia is a reading disorder, form of reading disorder. And another one is mathematic disorder. That is, the name itself easily we can understand. Its another form, its form is dyscalculia, calculation. So mathematics. So the children struggle to recognize and counting numbers correctly. So that problem will be there regarding the numbers. That is mathematical disorders. This is a alteration of learning, alteration in learning. So next one is disorders of written expression. Dysgraphia, graph. So you can tell dysgraphia. It means written expression. This condition is characterized by difficulty with written composition. They have problems with spelling, punctuation, grammar, and organizing their thoughts in writing. That's the main issue, dysgraphia. What they are thinking, they cannot express through their writing. So that's what. So this disorder of written expression also is, we can say, is a combination of reading disorders and mathematical disorders. That's why I mentioned like this. It's a combination of reading disorder and mathematical disorder. A disorder of written expression also is a form of combination of reading disorder and mathematical disorders. In reading disorder, we have seen dyslexia. It's a form of reading disorder. In this, child is having the problem to recognize and interpreting the letters and words. And mathematics disorder, dyscalculia, in that the child is having problem of recognizing and counting numbers correctly. And disorders of written expression, dysgraphia, in this the children will have the problems to express their feelings in written form, as well as they are having the problems in spelling, punctuation, grammar, and organizing. That these things will be there. So that is the alteration in learning. So next we can say alteration in memory. In memory, agnosia, amnesia, and dementia. So these things we are going to see. Agnosia means there is an inability to recognize certain objects, persons, and sound. Here this person is thinking about what is this. Actually they know this is apple, universally know this is apple, but this person struggling to understand what it is. When this condition happens, that is named as agnosia. Another one is amnesia. Amnesia is an abnormal mental state in which memory problem is there. That is called amnesia. Memory and learning are affected out of all proportion of other cognitive functions. Means out of all proportion of other cognitive functions. Yeah. But other cognitive functions okay. Only this memory functions will be affected. So that is called amnesia. Because if memory problem is not okay, and other cognitive functions also not okay, it is called as some other name. But only this memory and learning problem is affected, and other cognitives are proportionally no problem. It's not affected much, then it is comes under this amnestic disorder. So amnesia is two types is there. One is anterograde and another one is retrograde amnesia. Anterograde means the first we can I want to say retrograde amnesia. Retrograde amnesia is the before the incident of his amnestic problem, before that whatever happened he cannot remember. That condition is called amnesia. So anterograde amnesia, after the incidents of this amnestic problem, he cannot recall the anything happened in his life. Means after the incident whatever happened, that also he cannot recall immediately. So that is called amnesia. So anterograde and retrograde. Retrograde backwards we have to see. You see one picture is there. This is retrograde. This is retrograde. So this is anterograde. You see this is incident part. So before that whatever happened, this person after this incident cannot able to remember. So in anterograde amnesia, after this incident, whatever will happen in his life, everything he will keep on forgetting. So this condition is called amnesia. So dementia, next is dementia. This is a condition characterized by progressive deterioration of thinking ability, memory, as the brain becomes damaged. So that condition is called dementia. You see, these dementia patients will have difficulty to speech, difficulty to motor movements, tremors. These type of things will be there to these dementia patients. So next we can see hyperthymestic syndrome and Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. This also memory related things. This also, you see, this memory alteration in memory. So five things are we have seen in memory. One is agnosia, amnesia, dementia, and another two is hyperthymestic syndrome and Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. This hyperthymetic syndrome means it is a mental condition that allows the person to remember almost every detail of their lives with near perfect accuracy. Every part of the things happened in our life he will remember. So this is it looks like a gift of a person, but actually it is sometimes it becomes a curse of a person, because our brain is have a talent to forget the unwanted things. But these people's everything they will remember, so it will become a disorder. One certain point it will become disorder. So that is hyperthymestic syndrome. So next is Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. It's a severe neurological disorder. It is caused by thiamine, vitamin B1 deficiency. Usually this is happen to the persons those who are addicted in alcohol, because alcohol prevents the thiamine absorption from the intestine, the stomach. So that's why the thiamine demand will be there in brain. So without vitamin B1, the memory parts of the brain will be affected. So this also memory related Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome. It is usually associated with chronic excessive alcohol consumption. This is what I explained now. So, five things we have seen in alteration in memory. One is agnosia, not able to recognize the familiar objects. We can say like that. Then amnesia is a loss of memory. We have seen two types of amnesia. One is retrograde amnesia, another one is anterograde amnesia. So retrograde means whatever happened before the amnestic incident, he cannot able to remember. So anterograde is in the future, after this incident, whatever he is facing, everything he will forget. He cannot able to remember what he ate. He cannot able to remember what he said to other person. So like this will be there, that is anterograde amnesia. So dementia is a disorder characterized by progressive deterioration of thinking ability and memory problem. Thinking ability and memory problem. So both will be there. So in amnesia, there is no cognitive, all other cognitive functions may be normal. Only this memory and learning problems will be there. But dementia, most of the cognitive problems will be there. So due to the brain damage, it is happened due to the brain damage. That's why this dementia comes under organic brain disorder. Another one, hyperesthesia, it's a over remembrance. It means individual extremely detailed autobiographical memory. Their memory is very strong. Every details of in their lives he can remember. So that also becomes one problem. And then next cause of cough, it is also memory related problems happen due to the B1 deficiency. And B1 deficiency, it is mostly commonly seen with the persons, those who are taking alcohol every, means those who are addicted in alcohol. So this is about alteration in memory. In alteration in thinking delirium also coming, dementia also coming, amnesia also coming. Dementia, amnesia, already just before we have seen. Delirium means it also like a dementia condition, but it is acute condition. Delirium is acute condition that develops over a short period of time. Okay, so that is acute condition. Dementia is chronic condition. Dementia, conscious will not be affected. The delirium, conscious will be affected. There is change in consciousness. That is the difference. Otherwise, both are same. There is memory problems. And the learning problem, thinking problems will be there with that patients. Delirium and dementia. Amnesia already we have. Already I said. So this is about alteration in thinking. Next is alteration in intelligent. Alteration in intelligent, one is subnormal intelligent, one is more over intelligent. So subnormal, mental subnormality, its intelligence is very poor. Mental subnormality. In this, the people just those who are having very low mental power looks like this: a small head, low nasal bridge, small eye opening, short nose. These are those children who is affected by mental subnormality. The children's looks like these type of characters will be there physically, and mentally also it's not developed. That's why their reading problem, writing problem, language issues, memory issues, everything will be there. There will be certain different, types is there, mild, moderate, severe, like that we can separate based on their capability of their children. And another one is mentally gifted children. These children are very mentally sound. Their IQ is 140 or higher. But this is very rare cases will be there. In the early child, the gifted child is generally found to be misfit in his class. That is their problem, because they are mentally high, sound mind is there. That's why they are not able to cooperate with their same age children as well as adult, elder persons. Because they are easily, they will grab the things happening in their surroundings. So they will learn everything very easily. So that's why till their adulthood, they will feel some difficulty to mingle with the children of their same age and others. Because whatever they can understand easily, they think others will get little difficult to understand. So they will think there's some different is there. That's why they are not able to mingle with other children. And so these problems, till adult, they will feel very sad, they will be alone, these problems will be there. But after adulthood, they will be very happy because they are able to complete their task, whatever it was, complete their task in the any situation. So they will be very happy after adult. So this also sometimes it is becoming problem. That's why it is an alteration of intelligence. It comes under alteration of intelligence. Once again, I want to summarize all the things, all the alteration in cognitive processes. Alteration cognitive process, these attention, perception, learning, memory, thinking, these are all cognitive processes. So in this first, we can see about attention. Attention probably affect the mentally ill persons like schizophrenia patients and the ADHD children, because attention deficit hyperactivity disorder. So in perception, horizontal vertical illusion I saw, and the illusion of length I saw that how it is be our illusion is there, and in this also we have seen. So these examples we have seen, and next is learning. In learning, reading disorder, mathematical and disordered written expression we have seen, and memory agnosia, not able to recognize the familiar things, amnesia, not able to remember anything, and dementia is not it's also thinking abnormality, memory problem. These things will be there in dementia, and that is due to the brain damage. So that's why the name given dementia. Next is hyperemesis syndrome, Wernicke-Korsakoff syndrome, Wernicke-Korsakoff vitamin B1 deficiency. Then memory, so that's what we have seen now. So next is thinking, delirium, dementia, amnesia. These things comes under thinking abnormality. So delirium, dementia, amnesia. So I said delirium and dementia both are same. Only a few difference are there. That is the consciousness. In delirium, there is alteration of consciousness. It means changes in consciousness. In dementia, there is no changes conscious. There is no effect in consciousness. In delirium, there is a short. It's a acute condition. Dementia is chronic condition. These are the difference we can find in this. In amnesia, I already explained. So intelligent. So less intelligent, over intelligent. So about this we have seen. So thank you.